Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. set to be discharged from his COVID isolation by Friday. The president's physician, Dr. Samuel Zacarte, says Marcos has now recovered from his mild symptoms. Zacarte met Marcos Wednesday at an undisclosed residence where the president had been isolating for nearly a week. Malacanang says Marcos's vital signs are normal and is showing no signs of distress. The palace adds he will be issued a clean bill of health if his COVID symptoms do not reappear. The 64-year-old Marcos had his second bout with COVID a week after he assumed the presidency.
The Philippines logged more than 1,600 new COVID cases on Wednesday. Metro Manila accounted for 637 infections. No new deaths were recorded. Active COVID cases are now at 14,800, the highest level since April 22. The positivity rate from July 10 to 12 was said to be at 10.9%. Since the pandemic began, the Philippines has logged over 3,700,000 COVID cases, 3,600,000 recoveries, and 60,000 deaths.
Health officials are also expressing concern over the spike in dengue cases. Data from the health department show 15 out of the 17 regions in the Philippines have already exceeded the alert and epidemic thresholds for the mosquito-borne disease. So far, almost 65,000 dengue cases have already been recorded this year. Central Luzon, Central Visayas, and Zamboanga Peninsula log the most number of infections.
Is it worrisome? Yes, it is worrisome. Kasi nakikita po natin sabay-sabay ang mga rehiyon na nagtataas na ng kaso. It is worrisome because on top of COVID-19, we are looking at dengue cases also increasing. Kailangan po lang hindi magpanik, no? Kailangan gawin natin yung tama.
A Philippine health expert disagrees with the call to reevaluate the use of Dengvaxia vaccine. Infectious disease specialist Dr. Ronjin Stolante has urged the government to review the jab amid rising dengue cases in the country. But Dr. Tony Liachon points out the French drug maker Sanofi failed to submit risk management plans for its vaccine. This led to local drug regulators to eventually revoke Sanofi's product registration for its jab in 2019.
Kung meron ngayong pagbuhay ngayon sa usapin related sa Dengvaxia, they have to, the pharmaceutical company, through the help of their advisors, should actually talk with the FDA whether they have actually complied with the post-marketing surveillance requirement. Ang problema lang na nakikita natin, meron kasi regulatory at saka legal impediments. So definitely, hindi siya pwedeng ibalik sa merkado kasi may regulatory issues kayo.
Colleges and universities in the Philippines not required to resume 100% face-to-face classes. That's according to the Commission on Higher Education. CHED Chair Prospero De Vera says they will not issue a blanket policy similar to the Education Department, which mandated all private and public elementary and secondary schools to return to in-person learning by November. De Vera explains, unlike in basic education where there is only one curriculum, degree programs in higher education institutions are constructed differently. He also says flexible learning may become the new normal in the coming years.
Some degree programs really need a lot of face-to-face, especially skills-based programs, while other programs can be delivered by flexible learning. So we are leaving it to the universities to decide what is the appropriate mix. We cannot require all schools to do face-to-face because there are schools that have been doing distance learning and flexible learning even before the pandemic.
CHED has meanwhile lifted an 11-year-old moratorium that prohibited colleges and universities from offering nursing programs. The move comes amid higher global and domestic demand for health professionals. The CHED cites data from the Department of Health, which shows there are only 90,000 nurses in the Philippines, far short of the demand at over 200,000.
Since that time, we have monitored the passing rate in the licensure exams, and the passing rate has been higher than what the government imposed. The mechanisms that we put in place in terms of monitoring how the schools perform, looking at their programs, looking at their curriculum, shows that we have significantly improved the delivery of nursing education. Number one, we have tightened the criteria for new programs that will be opened. They have to have a passing rate of more than 30%. In the 3 years, once their graduates finish, we require a base hospital for the schools that will apply for programs. We will make sure that the problems encountered before the moratorium will not happen in this lifting of the moratorium.
The moratorium was imposed in the year 2011 due to an oversupply of nursing graduates and a gradual decline in their performance in licensure exams. With the lifting of the moratorium, schools may now submit their applications for review by the CHED.